Hey everybody, Kyle here, and welcome back to the finale of Let's Play Jet Set Radio Future. So, there's just two more things we have to do in the game, including fighting the final boss. But I'm going to go ahead and make this a finale because these things don't really take too long. But anyways, what we need to do to start off the end of this game is to go to the Skyscraper District. And just to recap, at the end of the last part, DJ Professor K was kidnapped, like after we took care of the Golden Rhinos. So now we need to find out what happened to him, and there he is. He's in the cage, in case you wouldn't have guessed. Okay, so Zero Beat appears here after DJ Professor K is kidnapped, and so we need to go talk to him and see what he can tell us. So Zero Beat is an interesting character who only appears during Chapter 8, and we'll see exactly what he is here in a bit. I don't think we get to interact with him very much until we rescue DJ Professor K. Oh, okay. Let's go ahead and talk to him, see what he's got to say for himself. ... Okay, he doesn't say anything. He knows that we've taken care of the Golden Rhinos, and I think he's a little worried. I mean, I would be. Okay, so he's going to skate off towards the side of Tokyo Line. We can see it on the map here, but we've never actually been to that area because you actually can't get there until this point in the game. So, let's see what we're going to find here. Hopefully, we'll find out where they're keeping DJ Professor K and we can rescue him.
I'ma keep broadcasting as long as I can. The Golden Rhinos brought in some sort of strange looking machine. What is that thing? Shut that damn thing off!
DJ Professor K is as confused as I am. Okay, so they're keeping him on top of this giant machine. And this is one of the more interesting like police fights in the game. And it's the most infuriating. So I guess they realized, okay, you know, we're pitting them against shitty helicopters and jets. So what could we possibly use that's better than those things to take down these guys? And apparently they chose this giant train death machine. Okay, so this isn't really that hard of a fight, if you want to even call it a fight. It's just more annoying than anything else, because you have to catch up to these, and I don't think they ever, like, slow down. So it's just a matter of getting close enough to them. And periodically, they'll put down those, like, electric things, which make it really annoying. Okay, we've almost got that part of it down. All right. So yeah, they have these electric things that shock the lines that you're on. And at one point, we're going to find that they're going to have two on each thing. Like, they're going to have one on each of the rails on either side. So they're definitely trying to take us down. And then they also shoot out these little rocket things. So those are annoying. Okay, we've got the right side, or the left side, rather, completely done. So now we just need to focus on this right side here. Oh, and I haven't, like, even mentioned this at all yet, but I'm playing as Soda now. And I figured I'll just give him a little bit of screen time. He's not the character that I want to beat the game with, although that really doesn't affect much. I want to play as a specific character for the final boss, just as kind of like, because of things that happened earlier in the game with that character, if that makes sense. So it's more or less just a personal thing that I want to do. And plus, it's going to be the only character that we haven't played yet. So you could kind of guess who that is. But yeah. So this, when I did this in my practice file, like this fight, it took me a really, 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 really long time. because I just wasn't doing things right and I kept getting knocked off of the rail. And I kept getting stuck at a point like this where I'm so far away from the machine that it's just annoying to try to get to. And it does take a while. It just takes patience. And now it's going to start tricking us. Like, if we jump as soon as it's coming down to a rail, it's going to retract its little needle thing, which is annoying. And it's not really that hard to catch up with, but unfortunately, anytime you jump, you slow down, and you get farther away from the thing. Yeah, look at that. I don't know if there's, like, a character, a specific character that would be good for this. Like, it would have to be a character that has a really good, like, speed stat. And Soda here, he has really high health, but his probably his biggest downfall is that he can only hold 25 spray cans. And he's also... I looked at his stats before doing this part, and he's actually kind of a slow character. He does have really good acceleration, which I guess is good, but at the same time, if he's slow to begin with, acceleration isn't going to do much unless you have spray cans. And it's kind of sucky to combine a character with stats that has like a stat that gives you really good acceleration that makes you go fast, but then makes you slow after you are done accelerating. Okay, so then they decided to put the needle right there in front of me. Okay, I'm getting close. I basically have him done. If I could just get up to him and spray him again, I'll be golden. I'm going to wait for them to put down the needles one more time. Okay. There's the triple threat, quote unquote. Okay, did I get him? I got him. Yeah, screw your train machine. And this is the only time you come to this area, by the way, so once we're done with this fight, we're never going to come back here, and you won't actually be able to come back here. So... hope you guys enjoyed this area while we were here, because we're not going to be seeing it anymore. But, okay, what happens now?
People of Tokyo! People of the world! Konnichiwa! Ni hao! And good evening. This is DJ Big Goji, bringing you a special broadcast of supreme culture! Rokkaku Bonzai Radio! To start off the night, I would like to proudly announce that, while it was a little behind schedule, the Rokkaku Expo finally begins today! Thank you, thank you! Now, I will show all of you the true meaning of art. The name of this tower of ultimate beauty is... yeah, blibbity blah blah blah. The name is irrelevant! What you must know is that this tower plays the music of the future of Tokyo and the entire world! Arigato, arigato! Merci beaucoup, Bandai! There is no use resisting. Come to the Shibuya Terminal! Hurry, hurry, Ishogai!
Okay, so things just got a little weird. Like, Rokkaku Gouji has finally made his appearance in this game. And he's in some kind of huge tower and basically calling everyone to Shibuya Terminal. So he is the final boss of this game, and we need to go take him out. And to do that, I'm going to go ahead and play as Cube. We haven't played as her yet, and she was the leader of Poison Jam, and she helped us figure out that the fake Yo-Yo was actually a fake. He was the person who was playing as Yo-Yo, or imitating Yo-Yo. So, you know, she obviously has some beef against the Noise Tanks and Rokkaku, so we're going to go ahead and play as her. Now, she's going to have really good stats. Actually, now that I think about it, I don't know how many spray cans she's going to hold, which is kind of what I'm concerned about. Okay, you know what? We'll just go ahead and see how it goes. She probably only has 30 spray cans. Hopefully not 25. That would be bad. But anyways. Okay, let's see what everyone has to say about Goji. Shibuya Terminal's in a state of panic. I really want to stay out of this, but we gotta go over there and take care of business. Okay, what do you gotta say, Korn? We gotta protect the streets. That's not a choice. We can't let these fools just waltz in and take over. You're right. Well, what about you, Jazz? We gotta save DJK. I can't stand listening to this music anymore. Okay, what about Rith, my favorite character? What do you have to say? Goji Rokkaku is kinda interesting, but I think he went a little too far this time. Yeah, I'd say. What about you, Soda? I got better things to do than play house with Goji Rokkaku. But man, that big ugly thing has got to go. What, man, what do you have better to do? You were just like standing around Highway Zero and you asked us to entertain you. You obviously don't have anything really important to do. But doesn't matter, because he's not going to be the one that takes out Goji. Alright, let's go ahead and go to Shibuya Terminal.
However, this tower is not finished, and that is why I need you, all of you. With your voices, we can complete this tower of ultimate beauty together. Now, wipe that pitiful smile off your face. Show me the demons inside you all! Oh, not the evil show, baby. Yes, that's wonderful. You all look so terribly evil. Now this is art, baby. The art of despair. Ooh, we spent so much energy fearing our own demise. Channel that useless energy towards the tower. It shall live there for all eternity. Abandon your hopes and throw away those miserable smiles. And now, here to guide you all are my beautiful children, Zero Beat! And DJ Beat Goji will provide the accompaniment. Oh, thank you. Thank you. All right, everybody. Let's dance! All together now! Hi-ya!
Man, this guy is scary. Okay, so one thing. Oh. Okay, one thing to mention about Goji is that he's actually voiced by. Oh, man, come on, stop talking. It's my turn. Okay, do I get to talk now? Please? Oh, he's still going. Okay, I think he's done. Oh man, she only has 25. She can only hold 25 spray cans. That kind of sucks. But anyways, Goji is actually voiced by Charles Martinet, which, if that name sounds familiar, that's because that guy is the person who voices Mario anytime that Mario has a voice. And I thought that was kind of interesting. I mean, that's something I didn't know until I was looking up trivia and stuff. But it's like, I don't know. How could some guy go from playing a super cheery character like Mario to voicing freaking creepy-ass, crazy Rokkaku Gouji? It's crazy. But it's cool also at the same time. Controller, I thought I was gonna make it through the finale without you acting up. But of course. Of course. Okay. But yeah, I just thought that was really interesting, and he gives a hell of a performance in this game. Like, I would say that it's even comparable to, DJ Professor K's performance in this game. You know, because the guy who voices him does a really good job, but, I don't know, I think Goji does a little bit, or Charles Martinet, rather, does a little bit better of a job as, Goji here. But anyways, so, what we need to do when we first come here is, spray the backs of these two Zero Beat characters. We have one almost taken down. Don't go to Chua Street. Actually, I don't think you can at this point. Okay. So, dang it. They lost me. Which is probably what they were trying to do. I want to take down the one that was really low health first. And he's, like, above me. Yeah, he's up there doing some stuff, I think. Hello? I've lost him. I really wish I had more spray cans. Like, I should have picked a better character. But this is okay. Alright, they're gonna come out over here. And I think this one is the one that we want because he has very low health. Yep. I think. Yes! There we go! There's one Zero Beat down, and now we just need to get to the other one. So this is just like, I guess you could technically call this the first stage of the boss fight. Because after we take care of these guys, we're going to go after Goji. Oop. Oh, okay, apparently you can knock him over by rushing into him. Okay, and apparently he changed his path. Now these guys don't actually spray your back. Which is good, unlike some of the other people that you have to face. And I think that's because, like, those were actually called, like, Tagger's Tag games. This, like, the description for this was to just, spray the backs of these guys. Up, 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 up. Just a little more. Okay, we should be able to get him when he comes out over here. Yeah. Come to me. Come to cube. Yep. Oh. Stop spray. Oh. Hey. Come on. Accept it. Did I get him? No, I didn't. Alright. Quit playing difficult. Ain't nobody got time for that. And there's all these people just running around like crazy. Getting in the way. Huh. There we go. We got him.
You leave.
Okay, so we defeated Zero Beat, but his tower is still here.
Welcome to the new Jet Set Radio.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. I think I'm gonna call it. Yeah, Jet Set Radio.
Yeah, get the name of the game in here finally.
I don't mean all that stuff that Nostradamus wrote. The future is one big blank slate, yo.
Oh, he's still sucking people into there though. That's not good. Oh. Okay, I guess you're not talking anymore, but your caption was still going. Okay.
Do not interfere with my masterpiece. My work? All of you, heed my words. My name is Rokkaku Gouji. I hold the keys to the future of mankind. The world belongs to me.
Okay, so as if things couldn't get weirder, okay, so now we're in some kind of psychedelic world. I'm gonna call this Rokkaku's perfection. I don't know. Yeah, I don't even know, like, how to describe this, but there's, like, all kinds of stuff going on in the background. There's these, like, shadow guys that just continuously chase after you. There is, like, all kinds of just things, random things from the world. It's crazy. Things are getting crazy, and my controller is not failing to get in my way at the last minute. Okay, controller, come on. We're almost at the end of the game. You can just bear with me through a little bit more, I think. Okay. So, hopefully the controller doesn't give us any more troubles here. Alright, so what we need to do is get to the top of this area, to where Goji is. And the way to do this is to grind on any of these poles and then just make a series of jumps. It's kind of an annoying thing. And it's going to be even annoying since I actually picked a character that has a very low spray count, because we're going to have to come back down here to get more spray. But there's a pole that I prefer to get to, and it's, I think it's this one right here, because this is like the path that I memorized, and it's honestly the easiest in my opinion. But okay, let's go ahead and try to do this. Whoop. You really just have to time your jumps right, and everything usually works out okay if you can do that. Some of those you have to hit, and then just immediately jump. I made that look a lot easier than what it actually is, but I've done this a couple of times already. Okay, so what you have to do is actually knock this guy down twice. You can't, as far as I know, you can't knock him all the way down to the bottom. Although that would be really good. So once you knock him down twice, then you can actually start spraying him. Unfortunately, I don't have enough spray, so I'm gonna have to go all the way back down here and then get back to the top. So I haven't talked about the music that's playing here yet, but I believe this track is actually called Grace and Glory, and it was in Jet Set Radio, and it is creepy. Like, it's perfectly fitting boss music, or in final boss music for this game, because it's got like that whole groovy, like sort of disco feel, and it's creepy at the same time. So I think it fits really well. And this game's soundtrack is just amazing, and I've mentioned that a couple of times in this playthrough, but it just, I don't know. It's It's one of my favorite game soundtracks. And the guy who did the sound for this game, Hideki Naganuma, he's done music for a couple of other games, and he's just a really good artist, I would say. Okay, so we could still spray him, which is good. At one point, you actually can't spray him. Like, you have to knock into him again, which is kind of annoying. Okay, we should have enough spray, assuming we don't die here. And assuming he doesn't go back to a point where... Oh, come on. If I have to go down for one spray can... Oh my gosh. Okay. Well, we have to go up one more time, which is unfortunate, but it is what it is. One thing I would recommend is if you're trying to get back down here, just grind on the staircase and then do some jumps so that you don't actually end up taking falling damage. I mean, there's health down here if you need it, but yeah, it's best if you can just avoid having to get health at all, if that made sense. Okay. So, we can still spray him. And that's it! We did it!
Man's desires crumbled as the tower was once again nothing more than steel and glass. These scraps of paper we call money, oppressive laws set forth by corrupt men. None of these can ever extinguish the yearning for freedom felt in the hearts of all mankind. Graffiti souls are the symbols of Tokyo's freedom. And the more people are pushed, the stronger that yearning for freedom becomes. And in the end, he was not strong enough to overcome that power. He had been doomed from the beginning. However, his existence might be nothing more than a symbol of the guilt that people feel for all their greed and desire. Or perhaps Tokyo has shown that it is one giant radio brotherhood. Perhaps he too realized this in the end. Those that seek the truth will fight tooth and nail to find it. Better believe that. And so, the radio will once again play static and worn-out tune. And the TV will return to being nothing more than a square plastic box. Our world is normal again, all right. But the graffiti left on the walls will remind people of their inner passions. It'll burn into their minds. And the dreams of the city will be carried on through the streets. People gonna remember.
In the end, Gokkai Goujo disappeared and the streets were something. We don't need constant reminders that we saved the day. It's not about that. All we wanted was to live freely, for everybody to get hyped for fun. That is all. Hey, time to turn on the radio. Wow, I just realized that at the beginning of the playthrough, I said that Korin was my favorite character, and we only played as him for, like, one episode. Holy crap. Okay, so that's it. We have completed the story of Jet Set Radio Future, although there's still going to be more things we're going to have to do. And real quick, I just want to outline the things that we're going to do in the end game before we actually call this playthrough complete. So we still have to find a couple of the mystery tapes that we didn't get in some of the levels, and we need to do that so that we can actually do the challenges in each area and unlock all of the graffiti souls. And so that's one thing. Another thing we need to do is actually collect all of the graffiti souls. So there should be about 125 altogether. Actually, there's 140 in total, 125 that you have to actually find and collect, and then you get 15 from unlocking certain characters. So that actually plays into the third thing we need to do, which is actually go and unlock all of the characters. So to do that, you have to complete all the challenges in each area, get all the graffiti souls in that area, and then do some what I'm going to call jet challenges in each area. And those are actually going to be a little difficult, but we'll get to those. And then the final thing that I'm going to do for this playthrough, and I don't even know if I'm going to show this, but I want to go through and spray all of the new graffiti points that appear basically after you defeat the noise tanks. So, yeah. So, get all the cassettes, complete all the street challenges, collect all the graffiti souls, unlock all the characters, and then spray all of the new graffiti points. Those are the things that I'm going to do in bonus videos, but the core part of this playthrough is done. We beat the story mode, and that's it. The ending was actually pretty cool, I think. DJ Professor K gives that little eulogy about freedom and the streets and how money corrupts people and oppressive laws always inspire freedom, and I kind of like that. I mean, that's a very, I don't want to bring politics up again, but that's kind of a liberal point of view, and I like that. I just like that idea of people being free to do whatever they want and not being oppressed. Because that's, you know, no one should ever be oppressed and told what they can and can't do. I mean, within reason. So anyways, going off of that point, I really love this game. I hope that you guys enjoyed this playthrough. It was a lot of fun. There wasn't one point in recording these videos and editing them that I thought, man, I have to actually do this. It's an obligation. You know, I actually enjoyed doing that. Like, I looked forward to recording these videos, and that's one of the first playthroughs in a really long time that I could say that that was true for. And it was also the first playthrough that I actually uploaded on a consistent basis, like an every weekday basis. And I'm really proud of myself for that. But anyways, is that it?
Oh, what? Come on, the streets are in trouble again? Who's gonna rise to the call? Remember, the streets don't wait for no one.
Okay, so let's go ahead and save our file real quick. And that's that. Now you can actually go and reload that file, which is what we're going to do after all of this gets through. And you can go back into the game you played, or that you just completed. But, you know, it's pretty bland. So unless you're going to do all the endgame stuff, you really don't have to even go back into it. But basically, there's no police, there's no Goji, there's no poison jam, there's no noise tanks, there's no one to fight. So, you know, the only point of actually going back in and playing the game after you've beaten it is to just unlock all the optional characters and get all the graffiti souls and stuff like that. So anyways, that's going to be it for now. I hope you guys enjoyed this Let's Play. I really enjoyed it, and I can't wait to move on to the next one. But before this playthrough is 100% officially done, we need to go back through and do those four things that I mentioned during the credits. But that's going to be it for the core playthrough. And I will see you guys either in a bonus video if you're interested, or in the next playthrough. I'll see you guys then.